Yo, what's up? It's gonna be one of those kind of videos. Sappy shit, you know. It's late at night, it's right before we're about to move out once and for all from our studio. And I'm just looking around. It's crazy how empty it is. Here's the podcast set. I don't know if you can get a better distant shot here. This was the Dr. Pock's apartment set. Kind of get a better glimpse there. Over there. Kind of see everything. This junk all needs to be moved still, but still it's kind of empty and echoey here. It's weird seeing the podcast set all gone. The dungeon set for Mega 64 episodes was in that corner. Another podcast set that we used to have is over there. The living room set, and now it's just walls. Green screen, all that. All the merchandise from upstairs is emptied out. We're moving out of here. It's weird, you know, I've been used to that. Honestly, like, it sounds sappy, but, you know, I spent a big chunk of my 20s here. So many, you know, I don't know. It's like, other than my own home, there's nowhere else I've been more. You know, and it's just weird, like, something that's been a part of your life that long. It's crazy not having it anymore. You know, it's just a building. But some of the most, you know, I don't know, formative or biggest moments of my life were here, you know, kind of. This wasn't our first studio. It was our second one. We were at our first one for a couple of years. And then this one came along and we were here for 9 years. Almost nine, maybe a little less, but still, man, it's crazy. You know, and I remember thinking it was so cool. We had like a little bungalow to go up into. Of course, we would edit videos in here. I mean, you know, you wouldn't even believe how long I took. I mean, it's a mess in here still. We got to move stuff out, but how long I spent in here sometimes. Sitting right in this corner, editing videos one after another, after another, after another. There were times that I slept here for days to finish stuff in this corner. I would sleep over on a couch right over there for 2 or 3 hours and just get right back to it right there. You know? Yeah, it's just weird to see it all empty. Feels almost wrong, but when you gotta go, you gotta go. Speaking of that, bathroom was in here. All the stuff is taken off the walls. A lot of people always commented how like a lot of the like doors and some of the stuff on the walls here was kind of gross. It used to be a car shop. So there was always stuff that was like, you know, it was like oil and stuff. I mean, it was just really wasn't made to be a production studio, but you know, we made it work. But it would get so hot and cold in this warehouse, that really like, it's never like just right out here. It was always, you know, super hot or super cold. Back here in these rooms, this is where this looks like some kind of nightmare sex dungeon, but this is where we would keep all the DVDs and this little basically we had you know, the shirts and merchandise that would have been up there, but in here we would keep all the boxes of DVDs, you know, we'd keep stock of all the stuff like you know, our Blu-ray box set version 1, 2, and 3 or Nighttime, Time Travelers, all that kind of stuff. would be in this room. And I remember it would always be neat to me to go in here and kind of just stand around and look, like, in this little, like, fucking dank, damp dungeon of a room were kind of like recordings of all our adventures. You know what I mean? I don't know. There was something kind of entertaining about that thought. You know, it was just like, in this little dungeon was, I don't know, it was like a compilation of all of our lives, and each piece of it would get shipped all over the world. I don't know. That was always a funny thought to me, that all these things that we did were contained on little discs in this room, and people all over the world would take them and watch them, and I don't know. Anyway, like I said, this was an auto shop, so there was always like shit all over the walls and stuff. And this in here was our costume closet. And this looks like a dungeon now too, but it was full of costumes at one point. Yeah. Take a look upstairs. This is where mostly all of our merchandise would be. I guess there's still some boxes up here. You can barely see anything, I apologize. But used to be racks and racks and racks of stuff here. And it wasn't enough room, so it would spill out onto the ground. We would have to fold a billion shirts. Well, I say we. I never folded. The other guys did, but they would put them all right there. And it would get in the way of filming. It just overflowed everywhere. It was terrible. There's still some stickers up here. The Horse of Room. Mega 64 stickers. Still around. I don't know. Like I said, it's just a big ass, messy ass building, but I get sentimental about stuff like that, again, because this was like my second home, kind of, you know? Spent a lot of time here and just, I don't know, it's hard to imagine not being here. Even though, again, this facility wasn't really conducive to making videos. We did it, you know? It was like you fought through it and made it happen, so. We did it for 9 years, so we must have been conducive for something. But anyway, still got to move a lot of this stuff. A lot of things going over here. This was a sign for version 3. This was no genies allowed. No genies allowed because it was people who wanted a wizard. Yeah, I guess you have to watch the DVD to make sense of that. Signed video games live poster, all kinds of stuff. There's the Mega 64 system itself. Computers. Jason Voorhees, that's his mom. Yeah, anyway. Yeah, it's just weird to think I won't be coming here anymore. Anyway, that's pretty much it. Just kind of going around, poking around, stuff like that. Yeah, this might be the last thing I record in here. Like I said, it was a very strange place to make videos, but it was our strange place. Anyway. So we'll see where we end up next. It's a dirty ass sink. Toilet under there. Check this out. Packing peanuts.